So yesterday we have seen how to simulate this particular design. We were actually trying to focus things like this. We have a project. In this project, there are two files. How do we handle that is the one thing that we are trying to explain the guys, new learners. How do we handle when multiple files are there? That is the one thing. The second thing is, if multiple files are there, how do we associate test bench with a particular file? Particular design file. We have design for two design files here. One is a counter, the other is a design underscore top. So if I want to test counter alone, then how do I associate my test bench file with counter alone? And if I want to test design underscore top, then how do I associate my test bench file with the design underscore top? So that is the second learning objective. The third learning objective is to demonstrate about this parameter and DOM. So coming to this synthesis part here about this, because yesterday we have seen this simulation of this counter. Today we will see the simulation of this top. We have to develop the test bench, and we have to synthesize this one, top and also counter. So let us begin our discussion with that. So we have now, let us go to our this counter. In this counter, the question was asked earlier, if I synthesize this counter, so what will be the outcome of this result, that is the ultimate product? Will it act like a up and down app both, or will it be fixed to only one? If fixed to only one, will this the current shown? Will it act like a down or up? Those were the questions. So now the answer is, instead of asking everyone, let us go and understand this one. So what is that going to happen here, this particular design? If everybody kindly focus. You see here one square shape here, the other square shape here, the other square shape like a triangle here. Can Satish, can you able to see where I'm hovering my mouse?
Yes sir. It is in green color, top so, level.
Yeah. So guys, there if this one I select, if this one, this design underscore top, you see here changes in this processes window. Several things. For example, synthesize you see, implement design you see, and then generate programming file you see, configure target device you see, analyze design using chip scope you see. Several things you are seeing when this has been selected, this design underscore top. If I select the other one here, that is counter, nothing is seen. So the point here is, this is made top level. That's why all things are seen. If I make this one top level, like if, to make a top level, I have to right click that particular design file. And here you see set as top module, set as top module. If you do that one, then it will prompt. It will prompt here. Just a moment. It will prompt here, like whether you want to set this one as a changing the top module setting will cause these guys present. Somebody trying to present, don't do that. Yesterday also some guy tried to present. Today the guy who tried to present, I did not notice. Kindly, those guys who are trying to join through mobile phone, it will ask two possibilities. One is join, the other is present. So you have to press the join instead present. So possibly that is the mistake somebody doing. Kindly abstain from that. Okay. So back to the discussion here. So is it visible, Satish? Can you once...
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Okay. Changing the top module setting will cause the implementation status of the current design to be reset. So that is what it is prompting. So we have to say, yes, no problem. Let us reset. So now if you see those triangle, you see it has come with this counter. So now with counter, though counter file been selected, now everything is seen. Earlier when this design underscore top was selected, you were seeing all of them here. But now if design underscore top been selected, you don't notice them here. The reason, it is not a top module now. We made a top module counter now. That's why related to counter, all these processes are seen in this processes window. This is called processes window. So now I hope this is clear. The very first objective is how to play with the multiple files in your project files. If you have, suppose say you are performing arithmetic unit. In arithmetic unit, you have one module, vision circuit, the other is a multiplication circuit. So the other is a maybe addition circuit. So if multiple are there in your arithmetic unit alone, then sometimes you want to see what is the logic consumed by multiplication unit, what is the logic consumed by division unit, what is the logic consumed by some other unit. So in that case, you may have to switch between them. So at that time, this is useful. So now our intention is, we have in our current project counter, design underscore top and counter. So what we are trying to understand now, this current counter, this design file, how it is going to behave. We call it as a, so this is a leaf. Everybody, I think this, let me zoom this one somewhere here, zoom. This one, fake. I am forgetting that you're fake. Okay. This leaf cell, further divisions are not possible. To that extent, if we could able to reach, then that is called leaf cell. So in our current design, the leaf cell is this counter. Using this counter, we are going to upgrade the counter itself. This counter is fixed for this n equal to 2, that is 2-bit counter. So using this, we can make maybe a 10-bit counter, maybe 15-bit counter, just because the reason, this is a parameterized module. So this is our, now this leaf cell, we are going to synthesize and we are going to understand what it is going to give us, the hardware. So if you see this one now, because we made a top module, now we come here, that is synthesize. If you expand this plus sign, we have RTL schematic, technology schematic, check syntax, and then this is generate post synthesis simulation model. So in among them, we have business with this RTL schematic, technology schematic. This one, generate post synthesis simulation model, it's related to advanced topic. Later on, we will cover this one. But currently, basic level course, we try to understand the difference between RTL schematic and technology schematic. So let us run this one first. If I double click this one, then it is asking me to save this file first. So yes, I'm pressing yes. Then this is synthesized. It takes some time. Okay, so it has got synthesizer now. Now if you click this RTL schematic, double click, this counter design you got, this one. If you double click further here in this area where I'm hovering my mouse, further if I double click, there is nothing that I can see. So if I zoom out, so this is the visibility that I have. The picture that you see is this. This is something like we already have seen several times saying that a designer will have some information, black box level information, like primary inputs information, primary outputs information. That's it. Inside what is there, it will not be known to the RTL developer. So this is a black box represent our block diagram. So this sort of thing that this RTL schematic will give us. Inside details, you double click, no, nothing that is going further. So it's a simply, I zoom it. It's simply this port, one port, and the other port, and the other port. Three ports, and some port here, output port. And this is internally that has generated some clear. This port we did not use. So it has generated something like that. Now if you come to this technology schematic, and if you click this one, at the top level, it is seen same. See, these are the things I am using here. Left side, where I am hovering my mouse, see, next schematic, previous schematic like that. So if I double click, some inside it has gone further. So I just come here and I put this previous schematic it is showing. If I click this one, the top level, you will see. So same, this RTL, where I'm hovering my mouse, this tab, if you see RTL 1 is seen to you. So if where I'm hovering my mouse here, is there Tech 1. And Tech 1 is also similar to RTL 1 at the top level. But if you go to Tech 1 and if you double click this one inside, you'll see something like this. Let me make a space here. Okay, so this one you are able to see this one inside. I zoom this further. View. Okay. Now you see there is a FDRE. Some flip flop it is. Some D flip flop, and it is having this potential. These are related to this. I'm double clicking. This what is this FPGA? This FPGA inside this FPGA there are some LUTs, lookup tables. That is LUT lookup table, and some D flip flop. And some MUX logic. So with the help of this FPGA, inside FPGA, what is there? Some other day I will talk, but for now, what is there inside? Basically, one LUT, lookup table. It's a RAM, it's a, just a RAM, static RAM. The RAM. And there is a D flip flop. And there is a MUX. So these are really the fundamental blocks inside the FPGA, which helps us to build the logic that we are looking for. The logic that we are looking for here is this counter logic. This counter logic, this program, whatever you wrote, RTL code, this RTL code is translated to this one. Inside the FPGA, if you lookup table here, this lookup table, if you double logic been developed so that counter behavior ultimately we can see inside this lookup table. But inside this FDRE, if you double click, nothing comes because inside it's a flip flop. So some other day I will demonstrate this FPGA inside FPGA everything. So but the point that I am trying to make here is we had noticed this tech file and RTL 1 file. RTL is a just top level. How do we draw? We draw simply, we say, Baba, this is the counter. And I have something called input clock and something, another input reset and some output I have. So that's how we represent. We don't talk about inside what is the logic. At the top level, when we talk about the top level, we simply say there is a counter, some inputs are there, and this is some output. And it is a up counter or down counter that we put here inside, and we say this is a counter. That's it. So that is what exactly happening in a RTL representation, view RTL schematic. That is what exactly happening. But coming to the technology, that is not going to happen. What is that going to happen for this design file? this design, whatever the design, in this example, we took the counter example. It could be anything, 805, 805, 8086, or any other processor design, maybe RTW may be doing, or any DSP processor, or any filter design, it could be anything. So, but ultimately, this entire thing is mapped to hardware. Hardware of this target board, this target board. Inside this target board, we have those things. I was talking about there is some flip-flop and some mugs. So ultimately, our logic is targeted to either of this inside, depending upon what logic is. Everything is who is going to look into. Synthesizer tool is going to look into. There is no manual intervention. Synthesizer, this tool is going to decide to this RTL code, to which of this component I had to target. So this synthesizer is making a tool in this FPGA design approach. So that's what the difference that I'm trying to bring out here. This technology difference between this view technology schematic, view RTL schematic. That difference I'm trying to bring out. So briefly, so you people might have got some sort of insight. What is the RTL schematic giving us? What is the technology schematic giving us? That insight is important. So having known that brief understanding about the logic here inside what is really happening, let us move to this one further. This you just keep inside in your mind. What is that we have now? Just let me one more time zoom this one. Instead zooming, first we'll zoom and we'll count. You have FDE here one, and there is another FDE, one lookup table. So the point that I'm trying to make here is this one. In this FDE one, another FDE here, there is a lookup table. Other than that, there is no other logic. These are, of course, some buffers, some are there. I'm just not counting them, buffers. These are buffers. They are reacting like an input buffer. There is an output, and there are some input buffers. And depending upon the logic implementation, that requirement, some inverters. I'm not looking into that. Major components of this flip-flop and lookup table. So this is what exactly is there currently with this 2-bit counter. Now I'm just closing this technology schematic. I'm closing from this where I'm hovering my mouse. From there I'm closing, and this RTL I'm closing. I go here and I put here that is instead n equal to 2, now I'm going to keep 4. 4 means 4 minus here, what is that happening? 4 minus 1, that is 3. So you have 3 colon 0, meaning this counter is going to behave like a 4-bit counter. Now, the question is that up-down counter, will it act like up-down? Answer is no. It is not going to act like a up and down. It may act like a down, or it may act like a up. That's it. So who is going to decide that one? That ultimately that hardware produced this parameter definition is going to decide. In this case, this parameter definition down we have 0. According to the logic, when down is true, then this is down counter. Else it is a up counter. Meaning since down is 0, it is going to behave like a up counter. So now I save this file, and now I come here again. I run this synthesis again. You see the question mark has come. The moment we changed the things here, that green tick mark has gone and the question mark has come. So let us run again. Now let us see that RTL schematic changes. We have first pointed that two flip-flops, one LUD. So now let us see the logic here. What is the change? Now let me go to the RTL schematic straight. So if you go to the RTL schematic and if you click this one, now you see several things. Earlier only one FDE here, let me zoom it, one FDE, the one flip-flop, the other flip-flop, one lookup table, that's it earlier. But now the other lookup table here, one more flip-flop here, one more flip-flop here, one more lookup table here. You see that change difference. So that's how the impact is happening. That is very obvious for you people here. There's nothing much to explain because for obvious reasons, it was earlier 2-bit counter, but it has become now 4-bit counter. And I was talking about this one, this particular hardware. This is now particular hardware. This hardware, when you try to configure onto your FPGA, here this is you use several things, but some other day I will explain that. But just I'm pointing here, generate programming file. We generate dot bit file. So that bit file we actually port onto the FPGA. At that time, that FPGA will work like a IC. So that IC, this where I'm hovering my mouse. This IC is actually now going to behave like just because this count down is zero. Since down is zero, this is not going to happen. This particular statement, this is going to happen. Means the hardware developed is up count only. So that's the point that we have, I'm trying to bring out here. Because several new learners possibly may think, possibly this may act like up and down, or I can make it possible like up and down at the same time. At the same time means once this hardware comes by doing some, this control here, you see the control here. Let me, you have the clock, you have the enable. This is the control, user having control over this. Enable here, enable, reset, user having control over. But user not having any control here to make it up or down whenever he or she wants. That control is not there. But what you see in the code then? What you see in the code then? You see in the code, it's not a port here. It's a constant value, it's a down. Depending upon that, you wrote the logic. When if this particular case is met, that is true, then this logic should be produced. When this is not true, then this logic must be produced. We are instructing the tool that this logic must be produced. So meaning what, we don't have the control. Now we end up with having a, this particular counter is a up counter. It's a up counter. So this is one point that I want to make the things clear here. This one point. The other point is, now let me close this one here. Now, I just go to this design talk now. For design talk, if I come here now, I have changed several things here. That is, I made this, let me keep the earlier what it was. Earlier it was 2, and just I'm keeping as it is. I'm just going to my design talk here, and I come here. I instead making changes, what I'm trying to demonstrate the second time, second phase is, I made the changes here in the counter file, but I don't want to. I just want to keep this one as it is untouched. But still, I want to get 4-bit up counter. I go to this design talk. I change simply this one here. I put 4 here, and this particular you see this one, this portion. Let me zoom it here. That is. This one, this particular portion, you see this one, these ports are actually related to design underscore top. Never ever have an impression that I will make the changes otherwise. I will make clock 2, I will make reset 2, I will make enable 2, I will make output 2, 2, 3, something like that. And let me make clock 2, reset 2, and enable 4, and let me make here enable 4 here, this one 4, so that I can remove that impression. Now I removed that impression. So now this particular, if you see this one here, you have clock 2, reset 4, enable 2, and out 2, 3. These are local to design underscore top. The module that you are instantiating here is a counter. And this counter related ports are this dot clock, dot reset, dot enable, dot out. These are related to this counter, and you want to bind this variable with this clock, and this reset with this, and this enable with this, this out with this. But this binding only you have taken this one, this dot clock, dot reset, dot enable, dot out, like that. This sort of binding is called named binding. this is one point that I want to tell, that these are local to this. Are there any queries? Somebody unmuted.
Hi, Jagir, Suresh here. Here you can see something the local inputs are reset 4, but you are reset 2, you have mentioned. I think you can check
thank you for that. Otherwise, So the point here is this sort of binding is named binding. You cannot mix here named binding and positional binding. Suppose if I put like this, I remove this one. And if you see this one, first one, the second one, the third one are named binding. The fourth one is a positional binding. Positional means in this one, two, three, fourth. At fourth here, if you see here in this case, one, two, three. Place it properly at this position. Let me save and let me run this. If you have that sort of impression here, even this one I need to correct, because my intention is to 4-bit counter. So this needs to be corrected. Let me save this one. Let me make this one, this design underscore top, right click, and then go to this, where is that? Set as RAM module. And yes, now the things you see them here. Now you synthesize this. You will end up with some sort of error. Let us experiment that. See that cross mark, no green mark, no yellow exclamation mark. If yellow exclamation mark is there, then it means your perfect check mark has come, means no issues, everything is set right, all right. But now it's something danger, that is cross mark has come. So that error is pointing here. You have this error here, one where if you keep it shows a finger there. And top also, you see the hand symbol there. Here also see that hand symbol there. If you click the first error, it takes to the internet, the Xilinx website. They have the database for this HDL compiler 23. This error, they have the database. If you click here, it will go there. If you click here, the hand symbol is, if you click there, it will point this sort of arrow mark. It point to this somewhere here, nearer here, some error is there. Like that, it is alerting us. So that is the point one must notice, one point. The second notice is, not necessary that where it is pointing, there itself is error. Nearer to that, somewhere we have to open our eyes and check. That also possible. Not necessary that wherever it is pointing, there itself is the error. Nearer to that, maybe before or after some mistake made. So that also we have to keep our eyes open and check. But current scenario is, it is correctly pointing. It is correctly pointing to that line, and saying that expecting dot found out 23. Here it is expecting this dot. So meaning what from this, what we are concluding is, language recommends that you don't mix named and positional binding. That is what language recommends us. So never ever do that mistake. That is the second point I just want to bring out here. So now let us run this one here. Possibly we corrected this dot out where it is, it's everything is all right. Possibly let us go, and this time we corrected. The moment you correct something and say, question mark will come. So we have to synthesize this one. Let us synthesize and let us see this time what happens. Okay. So here the perfect check mark has come, tick mark has come. So it means what, everything is all right. Now go to this again, this technology schematic, because there is no point going to RTL schematic. You got the point. It's simply this box sort of. But if you go to this, technology schematic, so this technology schematic, and double click this, and see the internal you know, harder produced. It's the same the way earlier we were actually demonstrating this count and making here four, and then we synthesized this one on this technology file. It was same. So from this, what we are going to conclude is this count is this leaf cell. This count, leaf cell, last cell, is leaf cell is a parameterized module. We don't really need to do anything with this parameterized module. We just produce a parameterized module so that later time in future course of time, possibly we may alter the count, you know, the number of bits. So that's why we just developed this parameter generic module. So now in the future course of time, I thought of having a 4-bit counter. I really don't need to go this and make the 4 here. I simply instantiate that module. I simply instantiate that module, and I ensure that proper binding is done. And I send this what is this parameter overriding. And this through this parameter overriding, I just made this current design as a 4-bit counter. Remember the point here. This one we did not alter it. So meaning what this design talk, default value is going to take that zero only. So because of this zero, we are going to end up having this up count. That's the point to be noted. So since this generic module is so cleverly designed, it can act like the hardware producer out of this, maybe a up count or maybe a down count. So how is that we are going to make that one? So here we have to pass that parameter value. How do I pass? The same way the way I passed here, that dot m. So what was that here in the my here? This is a dot down. So dot down here, if I come here, I close this technology file, I come to the top here, comma, dot down, and this time I pass here one. I'm just passing one, and I save this one. And I see question mark has come again. I run this one just to see the point here is something problem here. The problem here is down, you notice here lowercase. You notice here down is a lowercase, but what I was using actually uppercase. That's the problem. So guys, that is good learning. So make that one done. Save it again. You can run this one. Yes. So this is perfectly got synthesized. But the point that I am trying to make as a third point, so far 2 points we have seen. The third point is, if you go to the technology schematic, if you notice this particular hardware produced, you will hardly will know whether it's up counter or down counter. There is no possibility just scrutinizing this particular hardware. Yeah, this is the down counter. Such a pains are really not required. You don't really know. Don't need to do any research in this produce. Just to make a point whether it's up counter or down counter. So one simply develop a test bench for this, for which this top on it. So let us quickly develop a test bench for this. Everybody be attentive, because we should don't be wasting time. If I'm making anywhere mistake, alert me. So our intention is, now we are going to test this particular module. Now this particular module should behave like a is one, then it should behave like a down counter. That's the outcome. So for that, let us develop the test bench. For that, again, you know very well that three ways are there to get that wizard here. So let us go to this wizard. Now go to Verilog test fixture, go to top test, top underscore test. I just remove that caps lock. Test. So Verilog test fixture. Again, I am warning here, don't go to VHDL test bench there. So Verilog test fixture. Now ensure this is checked again. So now you come here. So this is very nice here. You can switch between. I just want to bind my test bench not with counter this time. This time I want to bind my test bench with a design underscore top. So there where I'm going. Instead going here, there where I'm going here. This is something we have to notice. Go to next, finish. Okay, nice. This template has been produced. So let us. That is there, no problem in industry that will be there. Okay, everything is nice. This is also nice. This yesterday I spoke about this, that the settling time of that particular FPGA that we have chosen. So let me zoom it. Okay, this one. Yesterday we spoke about that. So I'm just removing that one. This one is not required. So I'm going to keep everything here like that. Now the point here is I come here. I put an initial and then begin. And then my reset 4, should be, it's a negative reset. Possibly yesterday we experienced it a lot. So that is a negative reset. So I just want to make this one high somewhere, at a 55, hash 55, or a good amount of count I can take, hash 90, let me put. There I make this one 1. After that, what more I want to? This enable. If enable is high, then only count actually it enters into the count. That is also there. So that I make here. Here it's a surname. Hash 5 enable to, that is 1. What more? 15 I will make this one. 15 I am making. And what more here? This begin not required because only one reset I am having. And what more? Clock I had to generate. For generating clock, I am taking always. Always hash 5. For every 5, it is on and off. CLK2 that is equal to negation of CLK2. Because in this, everything is CLK2. Okay, everything is set right, I guess. There's no issues with that. Actually, this practice, I don't recommend this practice. What I'm doing, this practice totally flaw. This is totally ruled out practice. The actual practice is, guys, this one. Just to save time, I'm skipping those steps here. Don't save. Timing diagram. Everything timing diagram. Without timing diagram, you don't see any company guy. You show me one guy. Without timing diagram, he's developing test vendors. So this is compulsory. But for time, keeping the time constraint, I'm just from my mind, I'm developing this. This everything is done. Okay, let me save and go to simulation tab here. Guys, there are you noticing this one here? Several things now. This ENT underscore test one, you see, top underscore test, you see. Satish, can you notice?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, thank you. So if you notice this top underscore test there, everybody, you have several here, like, design underscore top. Under that, this count is there. So this is the hierarchy. It shows the hierarchy. So you see the top here. You see the top where this top underscore test, in which you actually you instantiated this design underscore top. That's what here, this design underscore top. But inside this design underscore top, if you go here, design underscore top, you actually instantiated this counter. So that's why you see this counter. So this is hierarchy. So the point here is important point to remember. Is you shouldn't be checking designs and running the simulation. You had to select the test bench file, then run the simulation. So ensure that you're selecting proper test bench file and then run the simulation. So if my Avast is not, oh my God, what is this? Reset not declared, module top ignored due to previous error. Reset not declared. Why this? Oh, this is the RST I put, this is RST N. So Satish, you would have observed carefully. I was telling everybody, be alert here. Okay, so something it has generated now. Okay, so now you see this area is congested. Several things are there, it means. So for, in order to get them, you have to slowly zoom this one. So if you zoom this one, now you see here some numbers have come here. Some numbers have come. Let me set right everything. Some numbers have come. These numbers, you see first 0, 0, 0. Now next somewhere, it is 1, 1, 1, 1. Next somewhere, you see here that is 1, 1, 1, 0. So this sort of checking possibly sometimes maybe some can do is we can select this out here. We can right click and we can go to variable I selected, this out variable, and then I'm clicking right click and then going to the radix and just changing to unsigned decimal. So I just change it to unsigned decimal. Now you see happily 15 and then 14, then 13, then 12. So like that, it is down counting perfectly. So this is down counting happening here. Is that correct? Let us go and check our design. If this is what we have done actually in this top module, we have said down value, we passed it actually 1. So if your leaf cell, if you go, if this is 1, this is becoming 1, overriding because of parameter overriding, if this is becoming 1, since this is becoming 1, so this should perform like a down count. So it means what? This particular hardware, now this one, is actually a down counter. So though if you have the impression seeing this one, though you have the impression seeing this one, newcomers especially, they may think that, oh, this counter is capable of counting down as well as up and down hardware it is. In fact, it is not up and down hardware. Either you can make it permanently a down counter or you can make it permanently up counter just because this logic. And this power has come because of this parameter. That is the one observation one must make there. Is the moment we want this leaf cell to work as a any number of count bit, I mean this instead 2-bit count, it can be n bit. That is the power of this parameters. We are actually focusing on parameters. The whole emphasis is over parameters. Parameters in a different ways it is working. Parameters in this way it is working here to use like that. And parameter is working like a bit also here. And parameter also will work like a delay. If in a test benches, you go to a test bench here. This one here you are using this 15. So instead here, N15, I'm keeping N15. So I can put here, what I can put here? I can put here parameter N15. What is that N15? I kept earlier what I kept here. Anybody remembering what I kept here? Can someone?
15.
What's the value? Oh, okay, 15. So that 15 and then semicolon. So now, later time you thought of working with some other, you don't need to go wherever that N15 is there. Elsewhere it possibly may be there. So everywhere it will affect if you change context also. This parameter is playing a role. So remember, parameter roles are different. So the power of parameter mainly comes with this parameterized module, a generic module. Now let us immediately go to our test bench. Let us demonstrate how the up count is actually going to happen. So where to make the changes to see that up count is happening, we have to go to our design file, go to design file. You go to this down, you make it zero, or you don't mention here. Don't mention this one. Don't mention at all. If you are not mentioning, it means the default value, whatever is there, that means that is the one point. So let us go where the top one. Top one, this one. Let me comment this one, this section. So now I commented this section. So it means what? I'm just not considering that one, this portion. Without considering that portion, now if I run this test bench again, let me close this one here. Do you want to save? No. Let me come to this simulation again. So let me go to this test bench again. Let me run this. Okay. So now again, something nice, some waveforms have come. So the way I said earlier, instead of observing all this, you go to this one, right click, radix, and unsigned number I'm just taking. So let us, now if you see here, from here onwards, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, count is increasing. 15, the moment it has reached the 15, now you see the 0 again. It is counting again, 0, 1, 2, 3, like that. So what we have done, did we write any code here for up separately, for down separately? No. Leaf cell, this leaf cell is same. We did not alter anything. And we did not write the logic also here. We did not write any logic here. For up counter, we did not write. For down counter separately, we did not write. Just because of this parameter overriding, this is behaving, this counter is behaving like a 4-bit up or down. That's the power. That's what my so far efforts from the day we started this parameter topic to convey that how powerful this parameter overriding is. That's the point that I'm just trying to bring here. And the point here, one more, this one I already cleared. Never ever mix what we call this named binding with a positional binding. That is the one point you have to remember. The other point is these identifiers, whatever you use, local to this design. Just because of names are same, earlier your tool has generated default, you don't think that there is a link between this CLK and there is a link between this CLK. There is no link at all. You are making the link here. Who made this link? It is you who made this link. You binded this clock of this counter, of this leaf cell counter, with this design top. It is you who made. You can put here clock. You can put here clock enable to. So it means what actually? You binded now, whatever the signal comes on this in this module, So be careful in binding the ports also. So appropriately we have to bind, otherwise we will mess up everything. So it is all the time preferred to have a named binding, not positional binding. Industry prefers named binding only, no positional binding. So this is the another point that I thought of emphasizing. These are local to this, and you cannot mix here named and positional. And if you want to have several like that, you can separate them with a comma, and you can put a one more point here also. This one here have named parameter overriding and positional parameter overriding. So positional means, if you see the position here, the first is coming in this one, that is N, and then come thereafter it is coming 0. So let's put here 4 position, just position, and let us try again the everything. So how it is going to behave, you'll understand. Save? No. Okay. So let us save this file. This file we saved. And any more changes here? No. Straight go to the simulation. We made simply we put a 4 here and just going to the simulation. We did not mention that dot and all. here. You have to make a note of that. We did not mention dot and up. So let us go to this one, the simulation. Okay, so this one again, you I prefer this one. It's according to your convenience. You can do anything here. So I just come here and see. There it is. Otherwise, you can do this also. That is zoom in, zoom out. So you have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Meaning it is perfectly working like a up count. Let us go here and put a, it has taken 0. Default, it has taken 0. If you take 0, default value is 0, what is that happening? This is happening. Default value. What I am going to do here, default value, I am changing to 1. Changing to 1. I did not put here that dot, down and all, I did not do. Simply 1 and save. So now go to this one again and run this. So now you come again at the same thing I'm doing. You just take this one. Now zoom in, zoom out. So now if you have, you see the 15 here, let me, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, like that it is down counting and it is going till 0, till 0. Again it starts from 15 again 15, 14. Just because what we have done, we have changed this one to 1. That 1 is actually overriding this here, this down, 1. Just because of 1 here, this is 1. This is taken by the compiler. So the hardware produced because of this one now top module, this top module is a down counter chip. It is not up and down. Both will not function, only one. And that only one in this case, if you synthesize this one, it is a down counter chip. So guys, there, this is also one important point today that I am takeaway point is parameter overriding is done with name and with position. So this one we are doing with the position. If I alter, then everything game will reverse. If I alter, game will reverse. Like 1, 4, I am making a blender mistake. The blender mistake is actually this one is going to tied with this n equal to 1 and 4 is going to tied with this 4 somewhere. Where is that? This 4 is going to be tied with this down 4. So we mess up everything. So that's the reason why industry what demands is, Baba, don't use positional. So it is all the time better use named only. Name is dot m. And you well know what is that count should be. So that way you take care. That is what industry demands. This is called named parameter overriding, not positional. Positional, you just now you I said if you alter the position, then what is the biggest blunder may happen? So that is down, and then put your wish, maybe 1 or maybe 0. If you don't put anything here, if you don't mention this at all, default whatever is there, that it will take. So that's how today we session we take several things. Actually, we presented here